Hello everyone and welcome to the lecture of the course Mechanical System Design, in which we are learning about design of machine tool gearbox. In the previous lecture, we have learned about how to draw a structural diagram, and in this lecture we will learn how to select the optimum structural diagram out of three structural diagrams which we have drawn in the previous lecture. If you remember, in the lecture before that we have learned how to write a structural formula, and we have deduced total 18 structural formula for the gearbox which we are designing. For the demonstration purpose, out of those 18 structural formulae, we have drawn structural diagram for three structural formula, and in this lecture we will learn how to decide the best possible structural diagram out of these three structural diagrams. For this, first we have to learn how to calculate transmission stage, which is used for eliminating the undesirable structural diagrams, then node method of optimization, and finally we will draw speed ray diagram. Transmission range is calculated for a single stage of a gearbox. It is defined as a ratio of maximum transmission ratio in a stage to minimum transmission ratio in a stage. For the design purpose, this ratio should be less than or equal to 8, so that there are not huge jumps in the speed ranges in one particular stage. Let us try to calculate the I stage value for the first structural diagram stage by stage. In this structural diagram, the first stage input speed is NX, which is lying between N6 and N7, and we have got two output speeds such as N6 and N7. N6 is lying between N6 and N7 doesn't mean it is at the midpoint of NX, because we have already seen in the previous lecture that this Y axis is not a linear scale, whereas it is a log scale. Therefore, NX can be calculated by considering the formula N7 by NX is equal to 5 raised to 0.5. similarly, NX upon N6 is also equal to 5 raised to 0.5. now let us come to calculation of I stage value for the first stage. The maximum transmission ratio in this stage is N7 upon NX, whereas the minimum transmission range ratio is N6 upon NX, which is written over here in this fashion. Now we know N7 by NX is equal to 5 raised to 1/2, whereas N6 upon NX is reciprocal of 5 raised to 1/2. On simplifying, we get this equal to 5, which yields a value 1.26. This value is less than 8, hence this stage is acceptable. We have to repeat this process for the stage 2. We have got two rays or two structures which are similar in shape in the stage 2. We need to calculate I stage value for any one shape, and that is applicable for the second shape. In this, the input speed is N7 and we have got two output speeds, that is N8 and N6. Thus, the maximum transmission ratio in this stage is N8 upon N7, whereas minimum transmission ratio is N6 upon N7, as shown in this calculation. N8 upon N7 can be written as 5, whereas N6 upon N7 can be written as 1 upon 5. On simplification, it gives 5 square, which yields a value 1.59, again less than 8, so this stage is also acceptable. In the third stage, the input speed for one of the structure is N8, and we have got three output speeds such as N12, N8 and N4. The maximum transmission ratio is N12 upon N8, whereas minimum transmission ratio is N4 upon N8. N12 upon N8, since they are separated by 4 speed steps, they can be written as 5 raised to 4, and N4 upon N8 can be written as 1 upon 5 raised to 4. On simplification, it gives 5 raised to 8, which yields a value 6.35 less than or equal to 8. Thus, the third stage is also acceptable, which means this entire structural diagram is acceptable for the next calculation. We have to repeat this process for all the structural diagrams. For example, in this particular illustrative example, we have got 18 structural formulae. So we have to draw 18 structural diagrams and we have to do I stage calculation for all these 18 structural diagrams. Now it is a cumbersome method, so we can apply one smart technique over here. If you observe this process carefully, you will realize that we need not calculate I stage for each and every stage. We need to calculate it only for the stage in which these rays are spaced far away from each other. If you observe this particular structural diagram, you can say that in the third stage, the rays are far separated from each other in the third stage. So even if we have calculated or verified I stage value for the third stage, then it would have been sufficient. Same principle we will apply for the remaining two structural diagrams for the illustration purpose. This is the second structural diagram. On observation, you will realize that the rays are far away from each other in the third stage. So we will calculate I stage for the third stage only. In the third stage, one of the input speed is N9 and the output speeds are N12 and N6. So the maximum range ratio is N12 upon N9 and minimum ratio is N6 upon N9. N12 upon N9 can be written as phi q and N6 upon N9 can be written as 1 upon phi q. On simplification, we get 5 raised to 6, which gives us the value 4, which is less than 8. Therefore, this structural diagram is acceptable. Close observation of the third structural diagram reveal that we need to calculate I stage only for the third stage, which will be sufficient to judge the entire structural diagram. For the third stage, one of the input speed is N9 and the output speed is N12 and N6. So the calculation is quite similar to the structural diagram 2 and we get I stage value as 4, which is less than 8. Thus the third structural diagram is also acceptable. We will end this exercise over here, but we need to calculate I stage value for all 18 structural diagrams and at least some structural diagrams will get eliminated in this process. The structural diagrams which are qualifying this criteria will be considered for the next stage. The next stage is node method of optimization. In this method, we take the first structural diagram and we label that structural diagram with node numbers as shown on the left hand side. Now please note, node numbers are labeled from top to bottom, whereas the speeds are labeled from bottom to top. There is a reason why we are doing it that I will explain at the end of this exercise. Now we have to draw one table which has got columns such as structural diagram, highest node number on each shaft, summation of node numbers and remark. For the first structural diagram, let us see. On the first shaft, we have got only one node number, so that itself is the highest node number and it's 6.5. So we have written it over here. For the second shaft, we have got two nodes, out of which node number 7 is the highest one, so we have to write it over here. On the shaft 3, node number 8 is the highest, so it is written over here. And on the shaft number 4, that is the last shaft, output shaft, 12 number node is the highest node. The summation of this value is 33.5. We have to repeat this process for the second structural diagram as well. So 6.5, 7, 9, 12 are the highest node numbers on each shaft. The summation comes out to be 34.5. For the third structural diagram, highest node numbers on each shaft are 6.5, 7.5, 9 and 12. The summation comes out to be 35. The structural diagram which is having the lowest summation of node number is considered as optimum structural diagram. Now let us try to understand how the lowest node number is yielding the highest, is giving us the optimum structural diagram. We all know that when we are designing a shaft, then diameter of the shaft is directly proportional to the torque carried by that particular shaft. Shaft diameter is an important design parameter because it decides the diameter of bearings, seals and many other components in the gearbox. So it is a critical dimension in any gearbox and it governs the cost and the weight of the gearbox. We also know that torque carried by a shaft is inversely proportional to the speed of the shaft, which means a shaft which is running at the slower speed carries more torque. Now we have to apply this discussion to the design of shafts, especially intermediate shafts of the gearbox. If you observe all the structural diagrams, the node number, maximum node number, highest node number on shaft 1 and shaft 4 are same. So the only difference is made by the node numbers on the intermediate shafts, which are different in all three structural diagrams. Let us consider design of shaft 2. In this shaft, we can achieve three different speeds, out of which this particular speed is the lowest speed. Thus, it will govern the diameter of the shaft. Now, if we have a structural diagram in which the shaft 2 has the lowest speed higher than this point, then that particular structural diagram will result in smaller diameter of the shaft. Smaller diameter of the shaft means we have got lesser weight of the shaft, lesser cost of the shaft. And it is not only about the shaft, it will reduce the cost and weight of the bearings, seals and all other associated components. Thus, lower the node number on a particular shaft in a structural diagram, that structural diagram is preferable. Therefore, a structural diagram which has got the lowest summation of node number results in optimum structural diagram. This particular exercise helps us in arriving at one final structural diagram which can be considered for further design. Mathematically, we can also say that if the values of x1, x2, x3 are in the ascending order, then typically that structural diagram is optimum structural diagram. Once the optimum or the best structural diagram has been identified, the last step is to draw the speed ray diagram. Speed ray diagram is quite similar to the structural diagram, but it has got an additional information about the motor, which is a prime mover to drive the input shaft of the gearbox. Thus, we have to draw one additional vertical line which represents the motor shaft. Similarly, we have to draw one additional horizontal line which represents the motor speed. Now, if you remember the problem statement, N12 for this gearbox is 1200 rpm. And electric motors have typical speed of 1440 rpm. So it will sit above N12. Now we have to join the motor point with the first speed point on the gearbox in this fashion. So this is the first reduction achieved from motor shaft to the input shaft of the gearbox. This reduction is generally achieved through a belt drive. So in this lecture, we have learned about how to eliminate some unwanted structural diagrams by applying I-stage calculation, how to identify the optimum structural diagram from the given set or from the qualified structural diagram. And once the optimum structural diagram is known to us, we have to draw the speed ray diagram. In the next lecture, we will learn how to decide and calculate the number of teeth on each gear of the gearbox. Thank you.